morning to you, and of course, thank you very much for joining us right here on Urban Television. It is Urban today, or the 17th of the month of Ramadan, which is May. A happy Ramadan Mubarak to all my Muslim brothers and sisters. It is the first day. We hope some of you have not come up with some excuses of having ulcers and, you know, trying to avoid the fast.
Just say who it is. Just say who it is. Who's come up with an excuse? Derek, me and you are not known for beating around the bush. We hit it on the name. Farouk. All of a sudden, he has ulcers.
He said he didn't know he had ulcers until today.
Until today morning,
but
he discovered.
This lung here.
This pain is ulcers. Sincerely. Sincerely. It's a holy month. Today is when he realized all these other days he's never known that he had ulcers.
Because, you know, he would enter here with you know, food, and, you know, he's enjoying himself.
Anyway, the beautiful thing is we can bully him as much as we want, and he can't do anything to us because he's such a bully, a very, very big time bully. So I must say, either way, as Derek said, Ramadan Mubarak to all our Muslim brothers and sisters, and we're wishing you all the best throughout this holy month. Now, with that said, let's not take too much time and dive straight into our first look. Now, these are stories that you could have missed out on, especially throughout the night or while you were busy yesterday. Now, the first story is coming in from Kenya. President Uhuru Kenyatta signs controversial cybercrime laws. Yes, it did. Now, the Kenyan president, Uhuru Kenyatta, on Wednesday signed into law a sweeping Cyber Crimes Act criminalizing fake news and online bullying, with clauses that critics argue could stifle press freedom. Now, the bill imposes stiff fines and jail terms for hacking, computer fraud, forgery of data, cyber espionage, publishing child pornography, or sending pornographic content via any electronic means. However, bloggers and media rights activists have expressed alarm over a clause which criminalizes the publication of, in quotes, false, misleading, or fictitious data. Punishment for this can be a fine of up to $50,000, that is about 42,000 euros, or up to 2 years in prison or both.
All right, then coming back to news in Uganda, Lord Mayor Lukwago proposes tax boda ordinances. The current chaos in the management of Kampala city transport sector is likely to diminish if the proposed boda and tax ordinances are passed. The regulations, which were presented to the council on Tuesday for the first reading by Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago, seek to streamline the city transport business to mitigate wrangles and to ensure proper management, while presenting the proposed ordinances before the Kampala Capital City Authority Council. Mr. Lukwago said that although he had sought to have the ordinances enacted in 2013, he was frustrated by some technocrats in the Ministry of Works and Transport, who reportedly said that the government would prepare comprehensive regulations for the entire transport sector.
Then moving on to a different continent altogether, North Korea suspends talks with the South Korea, threatens to cancel the U.S. summit. Now, North Korea said it was suspending high-level talks with South Korea because of U.S. South Korea military exercises, which it said threatened warming ties on the divided peninsula. Now, North Korea's official Korean Central News Agency, KCNA, also cast doubt on whether next month's summit between North Korea leader Kim Jong-un and U.S. President Donald Trump would go ahead as planned, South Korea's Yonhap News Agency reported. Now, the United States will also have to undertake careful deliberations about the fate of the planned North Korea-U.S. summit in light of this provocative military ruckus jointly conducted with South Korean authorities. Now, that is some of the news that is coming in from around the world right here with us on Urban Today, in case you missed that. But now, Kenya, you know, this cybercrime came out because of the last elections. Too many stories came out on social media. And I think this is why he's actually signed on this bill, the cybercrime bill. Simple as that.
But you know, one of the most interesting things that actually is that North Korea suspending the talks between them and South Korea. I think everything was
Bolton
just
came
too
into the story. It was
too good. Yeah.
It was such a good feeling for a minute there.
Yeah, it was a good feeling.
I think North and South have been... But you see, every country...
Trump is helping a lot with South. Remember the other time he was saying, was going over his social media saying that he's going to make South Korea very rich. And now here we are.
Instead of making America very rich...
He says America is okay.
America is not okay. They have too many wrangles within the country.
So ever since Trump...
They might be a superpower, but...
There's a lot of problems.
Take care of your own house first. Don't be a superpower, but your house has issues.
He wanted something to be remembered as. I mean, he wanted to be the president.
Every president wants to have a legacy. It's true. Every president wants to have a legacy. Mm. I don't know about Trump's. I'm not saying he's not done something. Mm. Something he's tried. Mm. But
you're too anti-Trump. There you have it for our first look. How about we get into our weather is going to unfold today. Being a Thursday, you need to get to know how to be prepared. The weather. He's our weather forecast. Turns out that Lira will be experiencing highs and lows of 28 degrees. You know, that's a couple of thunderstorms expected in that area.
Are you looking at me when you say Lira? I didn't say anything. I really did. Guys, I moved on to Masaka now.
Masaka is going to be
24.
Yes.
There you have not it. Bad weather there, actually. Really, it's not too hot and it's not cold. Either.
Yeah, it's cool
like
enough.
That. I like that.
So for Lira is what? Is it too cold, too hot? It's 28, though.
Lira, I love you guys. I don't know what they're all about. I do not know.
There you have it. How about we take you to what we call our press digest. Give you a reason as why you need to grab yourself Uganda's leading daily that goes for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings in our press digest. Starting it off with the new vision that goes for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings, 107 Kenyan shillings, and of course 1,600 Tanzanian shillings. And then for the Rwandan francs, it goes for only 933. There you have it. Now, how about we begin with the headline, Government tightens NGO financial rules. Experts fear policy could cause the withholding of funding by some donors. This is actually on page 6 right here of the new vision. Unlike in the past, where non-governmental organizations would finance projects at a will starting next financial year, they will be required to channel their financing through the national budget. This could actually stop some people from financing our different projects.
The thing is, most of these financial assistances that we've been getting, what English is that? But moving on swiftly. I don't think anyone even noticed.
No, let's
but
move
anyway,
on.
Moving on swiftly, I think it's going to help. Like, if we look at the case of the refugees, what happened to all that money?
Mm.
It went into somebody's pockets,
that's
basically.
Mm.
So I think them actually now having money in one place, now there's going to be accountability. Everybody is going to be asked, this money was sent to you, by whichever government. Like, Germany can decide they're going to send money to Uganda to take care of this and this issues. And then this guys, now the Bahatis and his team, are the ones to decide who it goes to. Then now those people will be accountable. Like if we give it to refugees, the people in charge of refugees, we need to know.
But you see, Didon, we've had people to, you know, come up and show us how they spent the money and what we call the accountability. But nevertheless, they never give us the exact where this money goes down. And what happens? They're not punished. They're not subjected to any laws.
Welcome
just
to leading
go.
A country. Happens in every other country around the world.
So will this actually help us?
It might help a bit. Eventually.
But not to a larger extent.
As they say, as I told you, as they say in Swahili, Sikuzamwizi, Nyarubana, at the thieves' days are 40. How many of them are now paying after they've enjoyed the money, they're living luxurious lives, but now they're paying? So there's always a day to be caught. But moving on swiftly with that, apparently, Uganda buys 6 passenger planes, and this story is actually on page 7. Why do we even have...
I hope we're actually happy about this.
So the government is buying these planes for the national airline.
saying it like as if it is something that is not going to impact anything onto the Ugandans. Flights are going to be cheap. We have 6 passenger planes coming in. You know,
Jumbo Jet is there for cheap flights. But anyway, I don't want to judge them. Let me see how it's going to work.
What do you think about this? First of all, we need a national airline.
Mm. Let's begin with a proper national airline. Mm. But is it the most important pressing thing that this government or this country needs? So, first of all, you're buying 6 planes that we are not seeing for the next 2 years. So that means until 2020. Obama, this was Vision 2020. This could have been Vision 2020. So they bought it just in time to show us Ugandans, but we told you we're going to buy new planes for a national airline that does not even exist.
So according to the story, we are not going to see these planes.
For 2 years.
But at least we know they are there.
My friend.
At least we know.
We are all human. Seeing is believing. This is not religion.
How in trouble will fare if UN shifts some of its services? That's coming in from the business news. The UN's presence in Entebbe has transformed the fortunes of the town. But if it relocates some of the services, as stock has been, the town will lose some of its gains. That story is on page 26 and 27, as far as the business aspect can be related to what is going to happen to us in case the UN decides to, you know, shift its bases. You can get to catch up with those stories.
On page 3 of the new vision, Museveni meets with a Cuban scientist. Let me tell you, the way guys have been showcasing, I hear how the Cuban doctors are going to look like.
Dude, I think they're just scientists. Let's wait for the doctors.
It's okay.
Scientists are always, you know.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, ladies and gentlemen. It is not what you expected. But anyway, back to the main story. Museveni meets up with Cuban scientists. Now, he met up with the Cuban scientists who have come through for a 10-day visit to develop a strategy into bringing of the Gavac anti-tick vaccine into the country. Now, this team is actually from a company called the Heber Biotech SA firm in Havana, and it's led by Dr. Hector Louis Morales, and will work with a Ugandan team led by Professor Anthony Mugisha. Mm. So let's wish them all the best. Let's see how things will happen with this. Mm. But just to let you know, it's not
the ones that were on social
media. The ones that were on social media. Those doctors are pana. Those were models.
A Acholi traditional leader abducted by rebels in South Sudan. The paramount chief of Acholi, David Onen Ochan II, said Ola and the aid workers were abducted while traveling in a World Vision vehicle for the field on Monday. Yes, the government has instructed its embassy in Juba to intervene and secure the release of the Acholi traditional leader who was abducted by the rebels in South Sudan. That story is also on page 3.
Also on page 3, we have a wedding. Uganda, we have a very big wedding. Ramaphosa's son, Ramaphosa, is the South African president. Eh? Mm. So his son is actually set to marry Amama Mbabazi's daughter. So Amama Mbabazi is gearing up to host Ramaphosa because they've come to pay dowry.
So Ramaphosa.
So should we call this our version of royal wedding, something we need to watch out for?
I think so.
I think we should.
I think so.
Instead of, in fact, Kenyans should pay to watch this wedding. Instead of them paying 30 million Uganda shillings to watch a wedding of Prince Charles, or Prince Harry. He doesn't even know we exist. Mm. At least Ramaphosa's son knows there's Uganda.
They should pay just like
so now
20 million just watch this.
No, let's give them a bigger discount.
A bigger discount, so like half price.
So if they decide not to take our UN nani, we tell them half price.
Half price.
15.
15.
To watch this
video. Only.
I've guessed. But moving on to more serious news.
Let's get into
about 8,000 cars fail inspection test. Now, last month's MPs table reports of the process that hired SGS to implement motor vehicle inspection and found that it was marred by a breach of procurement ethics. Now it has come out that 8,000 cars failed inspection test.
So what next for these 8,000 cars? What is going to happen to them? Are they going to be put off the road? What is going to happen exactly?
They have to, because this is dangerous. If you break this brake imbalance and the alignment on wheels, which seem to be the most common problem we're having, or mechanical conditions on Ugandan cars, it's actually going to cause a lot of accidents. It's going to cause, no wonder we have a lot of accidents, because if they do not go through these inspections, 8,000 is a lot.
It's a lot of cars.
It's a lot of cars, and that's a lot of debts, I must say.
So, given new news coming in from the land probe, probe queries NITA boss over 928 million land forward benefit. The NITA boss said in 2003, the chief government valuer had offered 15 million for the land, but the Sebuko estate beneficiaries rejected it. Saka said the family anonymously accepted a much improved offer of 928 million in 2015. From 15 million to 923 million. I'm so investing in land. I'm telling
you. But you know, that's where the money is.
In land.
Forget park. People are buying cars to show us Simanyi Range Rovers. That's not money. This land is the best asset to have.
Podium useless money.
I'm telling you. But moving on to page 5 of the new vision, row erupts between hospital and dead woman's family. Now, this is between the late journalist, that is Nuliat Numbazira, and of course the International Hospital in Kampala, over her death. This was after a childbirth cesarean gone wrong. Yeah, that caused her death. So the family is actually planning on suing the hospital. Catch up with that story and a little bit more.
Still, before you go off page 5, this is interesting news for the farmers. Government has introduced 32 disease-resistant crop varieties. Yes, the Minister of Agriculture and Animal Husbandry Fisheries, Vincent Sempijo, yesterday said that the government has introduced 32 disease-resistant crop varieties. You can actually get to catch up with that story and get to know what are these crops and how can you benefit from them as a farmer.
Now, real quick on page 7, MPs block the pay rise for science teachers. They said that apparently the MPs said the proposed salary enhancement for science teachers is unconstitutional and discriminatory as per Article 4018, which requires Parliament to enact laws to ensure equal payment of work, you know, for work without discrimination. I totally agree with that because I found it very... So are you trying to say art teachers are not worth?
You were so against that.
I was from the beginning.
Yeah.
Yes. But the man was not even good in science.
Besigye tells opposition to fight on. He says, keep the fight on, do not give up. That story is also right here in the new vision. You can get to catch up with that. We have a lot of regional news coming in from Chirunda as far as the hospital sewage is concerned.
It's very sad.
It's a river now. You know, too bad. Gulu News First Lady cautions schools on fees. She has warned both public and private schools management against levying charges that have not been cleared by the ministry authorities. Says you do not have the audacity of just increasing school fees without consulting us first. You know, send us a letter. A reason as why you're increasing 10% per term. If we do not authorize it, you are not allowed to do that. That story is on page 10 of the new vision right there.
Alrighty, on to international news. We're talking about the royal wedding that is happening this very weekend, of which I'm going to stress again, Kenyans are paying 30 million to watch in Kenya. I don't know if that screen is going to come with diamonds or a British
Prince Harry,
you know, visa
Prince
or something.
Prince Harry is going to give them a handshake.
Be like, anyway, so we do have the key figures who will be attending the wedding, and that includes, of course, Queen Elizabeth. Of course, the bride and the groom and his brother, that is Prince William. Prince Charles is going to be there. Of course, the man behind the man of the church of the hour is Archbishop Justin Welby, who's also going to be presiding over the marriage. And of course, apparently Doria Ragland, that is Meghan's mother, will also be in attendance. Yes, yeah, she'll be in attendance. The other half brothers and sisters, definitely not.
Not
but
allowed.
They're in the UK.
Doing
who
what?
Invited you?
We don't know.
They arrived before, you know. I'm like, why are you?
Well, of course, you have a lot more and letter and commentary. We have a business pullout for you also, courtesy of the new vision. You can get to catch up with more of those stories. We have something coming in with the relationship advice and then getting into the new vision sport as well. Giant steps. I will turn KCCA into the best sports institution in Africa, says the ED of KCCE, that is Jennifer Musisi, after their win against Al Ahly 2-0 actually, game that ended yesterday. Take us through Daily Monitor real quick.
Right, on the Daily Monitor, Kadaga rejects plot to block BOU probe, and this story is on page 4 of the Daily Monitor. Now, her deputy, Jacob Olanya, had last year directed Parliament and its committee not to investigate the bank until the disposal of the matter in court. Auditor General John Mwanga yesterday said audit starts today. And then, of course, still on the front page of the Daily Nation, we have a pictorial there of envoys to award star Ugandan women. That story is on page 5. We have ambassadors like of Turkey represented there. We have UN resident coordinator represented there. Miss Susan Eke of Norway, Deborah Malak of the US. We also have French ambassador Stephanie Rivol. I've met her and I can't pronounce her name.
The French ambassador.
Yes. Very cool lady, by the way. I think one of the coolest ambassadors I've ever met. But moving on, another summary story there is how police apps. How police apps for tracing lost persons work.
That was the app that was launched on yesterday or the other day. Now it has lost someone as well. Well done. Moving on.
Let's move on to other stories. Don't be cowards, Besigye tells MPs. Of course, look for that story with the Muslims start Ramadan today. And of course, who in Rukunjiri women MP Sikh race? Find out a little bit more about that. There's also more on the sports. There's business news. There's international news. If you're driving on the wrong side of the road, yeah, you'll be busted. What is going on Bukede?
Bukede is the name to Agutisa, Omukazi no mwana we basetata. That story is on page 9, Bakulated Fana Nicho Omukazi, Nemuala we basetata.
A woman and the daughter killed the husband.
Yes. I don't know what kind of world we are living in.
I give up with Uganda these days.
These are the people we are supposed to spend the rest of our lives with safe. But they're the same people that are leading to our deaths. Embaga yomulangira, tata omuwala ayongedde okujitabula, bili ku page ya kusatu, ebive North Korea, or one North Korea, yechusiza ku Trump, ebi nabe bili ku page ya kuna, byonna mu lupapula lwonna olwawano olwa Bukede, your news in Luganda, you can get to catch up with a lot more details. Abali za land found, baba chunyiza, ebi nabe bili wano ku page ya msambu wano mu Bukede wo, tukomeza wo moto kaza 999, kafelo wa polisi wa Gambia. Gambi moto kazi noziko miyo 999 so obiyambi buli just a call away. Asiko bulamu, you pull out right here in Bukede. You can get to find out with some of the medical herbs that you need to get to know about. Edagari ya hepatitis B liwe deo ekamuli. Page 15 chenoche unisate chitisa. A lot more in Luganda news coming in through right here. I don't know why Dylan is laughing, but
no, it's the way you say Jimmy man, AGD.
This is urban.
Yes.
We're
in urban.
There we have it. So that is it for the Press Digest. We've given you a reason for you to grab yourself the Uganda's Leading Daily. That is the new vision, which goes for only 2,000. We're going for a very short break, but when we do get back, Pick of the Day, we'll be talking about entrepreneurship skills for the youth to enable them an 11. Someone came in just all the way from German to make sure that happens. We'll be getting into that after this.